It's your lovely Abby Dagren, and welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today I'll be doing a video on Cancer rising and the importance of it, and the importance of knowing your rising sign and why it's a very unique sign to have your rising in. I'll be speaking on the characteristics of someone who has a rising sign in Cancer, as well as their physical traits and the way that they look on the outside, or they're more than likely gonna look like. Also, I'll be giving an example of someone who has a Cancer rising, who is well known and fits a lot of the characteristic traits and the look of someone who has a Cancer rising. So stay tight and get warm while we learn more about the Cancer rising sign. Please stay tuned for the rest of my video. If you have not yet become a part of the Abby Dagren family, then this is your calling and this is your sign to hit that subscribe button and that notification bell so you know when I upload new videos. Also hit that like button because I know you guys will love the video. Also, you can share this with all of your friends, family members, or anyone you know, or anyone you know who has a Cancer rising sign. Okay, let's get right into the video. Okay, your rising sign, or your ascendant sign, is how you are perceived by the world. So, before you even speak a word, when you come into a room and people feel your presence, that is what your rising sign is. Also, how you perceive yourself in a way. So your rising sign, when you look at yourself in the mirror, when you wake up in the morning, how you feel about yourself, and how you perceive yourself is your rising sign or your ascendant sign. Also, how you approach life is what shows your rising sign as well. What you perceive in life, how you approach life, and the way you react to certain situations firsthand is your rising sign as well. And for those who don't know, you have your sun sign, your moon sign, and your rising sign. And your rising sign is third in command. So these three signs really determine to a certain extent who you truly are. And when you're able to understand these three parts of your zodiac sign, you will be able to live life in a way with understanding. So when someone has a rising sign in Cancer, because Cancer is a water sign, they're going to be very intuitive. They're going to trust their intuition over anything. And for them, this isn't a bad thing because Cancers or people who have a water sign, their intuition is more than likely going to be right. So when they trust that intuition, they turn out to be right and they're kind of in the right way. So doing that, there's nothing wrong with it. And because this is their rising sign, this is how they approach life. If something doesn't feel good to them in their stomach, or if they just have a feeling something isn't right or something isn't gonna go right, they won't leave the house, they won't go to that place, or they won't commit to a project that other people may feel good about, however they don't. Their intuition leads them to making a lot of decisions. And another use of their intuition is by feeling the emotions of others. People who have a rising in Cancer tend to be empaths, and they also use their intuition to feel other people's energies. So they can walk into a room and feel your energy and feel how you're feeling at the moment. And there may be times that they may feel your feelings before you even notice your feelings. So at times they can be psychic and they can predict things that may happen in the future. And just like that, in regards to emotions, they may predict, oh, you're not so well, you're not happy. And you're like, what? Like, I'm so happy. I feel so happy right now. And it turns out that you end up not being happy. And a situation happens. So with them, they use that intuition with not only their emotions, but they also use it to approach life. Next up for someone who has a Cancer rising is that they're very family oriented. They love being with their family and they love having a familial bond. They love being close to their family. So these type of people more than likely will like be in a whole neighborhood full of just their family members. When they grow older and when they have children, they're going to make sure that their children go to the grandparents' house, meet their aunts and uncles and their cousins. They love to have family around them, and they love to have family in their own home as well. They're the type of people that you would probably go to in the family for advice in regards to another family member, and they are more than likely going to try to bring the peace with the family. They're the person that's the glue of the family, so they're going to try their best to make sure that everyone feels at home and that everyone's respected and loved. And they're the type of people that may be the ones that start family gatherings or come up with the idea. They do leave this on into their children. They do talk to their children about making sure that they have a better relationship with family members and that they stay as harmonious as they can for as long as they can. So the temperament of someone with a Cancer rising can be moody. They can change a lot, and they can be crabby, no pun intended, because at times they take up a lot of people's energy. And over time, when you take up a lot of energy, you can be very irritated and not too happy at times. So that's something that Cancer risings have. And in order to prevent this, try your best to just take time to yourself and meditate, or take time alone to yourself so you can get your thoughts together, so you can get everything together. Because I know at times it can be hard being intuitive and grasping everybody's energy. So this is the time for you to stay home by yourself, or just stay by yourself and get to understand your thoughts and just like purify everything that you've been going through for that month or week or whenever you feel as though you're irritated and just don't want to be around people that much. And I promise that everyone who loves you and respects you will understand that you need time to yourself, that sometimes you can't just always be the nurturer or the encouraging friend. And this is the next trait that we come into, is that some of the Cancer rising tends to be encouraging and supportive. They are that friend who will have your back if you need any advice, if you need encouragement, if you need someone to come to a game with you so they can feel support and they can feel so they're not alone. That Cancer rising friend is that person. And if you need that nurture or someone just to listen to you, that Cancer rising is also that person as well. Cancer rising people also value security. And this security is more emotional and mental security. So if you're not making their life any better or any peaceful, and if you're bringing a lot of drama into their life, they're the type of people that will just not tolerate it, and they will try their best to distance from you as much as possible. They try their best not to have a lot of communication with you because it drains their energy, and that emotional security is needed for them. Other characteristic traits of someone with a Cancer rising is that they're very kind, and that they're very imaginative. They're very sympathetic, and they do have a retentive memory. Also, they're the type of people that when a situation goes down, they go into their shell and they try their best to understand all of the information, and they will decide how to respond after, because a lot of people, when they hear information that they may not like or information that is sad, they will just react all at once. But Cancers rising, they tend to just look at the information and let it digest, let it sit there, and before they react, they make sure that what they're saying is what they mean, and they try their best to take all considerations before answering any question or giving their advice on anything. Lastly, I'm going to be speaking on the physical traits of someone who has a Cancer rising. So they tend to have a round face. They do have an almond-shaped eye. Both of their eyes are shaped this way. They look younger than what they really are. And they tend to have slender arms and legs. And someone who would fit this description perfectly would be Farrah Fawcett. And rest in peace to her. You can see that she always had a slender look, slender arms and slender legs. She always looked younger than what she truly was. Also, she had a round face, which is something that someone with a Cancer rising would have. And also, she was very kind, very imaginative, very sympathetic. And also, she had those almond-shaped eyes. So everything in regards to the characteristic traits, as well as the physical traits, Farrah Fawcett matched to the T. Well, that is all I have for you lovelies today. I know I haven't been on for the past 2 weeks. I was on vacation, and I did have a good time, you guys. Thank you guys so much for loving me, and I appreciate every last one of you guys who support me. But yes, I will be consistent back again, putting videos up, and I'll be adding a new segment. So you guys, I can't wait to share that with you guys. What do you guys think about the Cancer rising and everything in the video? Do you agree with it? And let me know your rising sign down below. Also, follow all of my social media accounts, which are on the screen. They're also linked down below as well. Also, subscribe to the channel, as well as share this video with all your friends or anyone you may know who may be interested in this information. Also, hit that notification bell so you guys know when I upload. Also, comment down below and let me know how you feel, whether you liked it or disliked it. And just add more information if you can as well. I love you all, and please stay safe and healthy. And know that you're loved, regardless of what other people tell you, and that you're important and that you're precious. Bye, lovelies. See you next time.